And now we see the full route from the men. Now, a final male climber in this 2018 UIAA Ice Climbing World Cup final here in Hohhot. It's Russia's Alexey Dengin from Moscow. Gold medalist in Sazfei 2 weeks ago. Co-commentator in the finals last week in Rabenstein.
Alexey Dengin from Moscow.
So Dengin now in that disc, approaching this dynamic move. We've seen people span it, we've seen people jump. What will Dengin opt for? He trains moves like this all the time. Whoa, so good. Do you know, I knew he was going to jump, Kendra. He said to me last week off air that he trains dynamic moves in training. All the Russians laugh at him, and they always say, when are you ever going to have to do that? And of course, he stuck the move in Sazfei, and he's looking at that move and just thinking, come on, try
My favorite move there. Oh, we're going to replay the jump.
All points off. Yeah. It's like he did it just to show that he could. It was completely unnecessary, but so good. And then with the big mantle to make clip number 7, oh, Alexey, you are a Bobby Dazzler. Matches in on the top of that very small circular hold. Big fig 4. That's clip number 8. And he's quite a ways behind the pace so far.
Definitely doesn't rule him out yet.
Reaches across into that powerful shoulder move with the left hand. There's clip number 9.
Straight into the intellect.
And he skipped that hold. Reaches up with the right hand. Now, where skipping that hold seemed to have cost the other guys time, I actually think it's gained Dengin some time because he just moves so quickly into that backhand with the right. 29 seconds off the pace. That's much, much quicker. He's made up a whole minute there. Behind our fastest climber to that point, which was Noah Bake of Canada. Climbed so well in his first final of the season. No, yes, no. He made finals last week in Rabenstein. Just having a little internal argument with myself there.
We'll
stay externally.
Someone here is accusing Alexey of watching too much cliffhanger.
Yes. Do you know what? He has seen it. We were talking about cliffhanger last week. He's made the clip at 11, reaches across with the right hand, and he's gaining time with every move here. Come on, Dengin.
Come on, Dengin.
big reach behind him into that backhand Stein by clip number 12. Pulls the rope across himself to clip. Lost a little bit of time there, but he's still moving well enough. We can see that the Tomilov brothers, who both reached the top, were a good 32 seconds behind him. There's Aaron Montgomery of the USA. Dengin flowing through these moves. They call him Yosha. That's his nickname. Don't know why, but it is. 13 seconds off the pace. This is excellent speed here from Dengin. Easily into that fig 9 over the right hand. Back into the 4 over the left. Just watching people talking. Ima Swigin and Munshinshin there talking about their climbs. Ima now with a bronze medal. Rei Tolkanina with a silver. Munshinshin with the gold. Dengin at clip 14. Just struggling to find that position. Noah Bake had the same trouble on that pentalog. Hits it with the right hand the second time. Kicks across. And I have to say, Kendra, he doesn't look tired.
No. Looking solid.
Those shakes are very relaxed. Oh, little slip there with the left foot. And at this point, this is where we need to see a pickup of the pace from Dengin. He untangles the rope from his axe. Matches in high. Into the fig 9.
接下来已经即将要从屋檐上面翻出去啊，到了
matches in, switches to the 4 over the right hand, uses the left hand to stabilize himself and make clip 16. Come on, Dengin. 6 seconds behind Kuzovlev, who lost some time here. The fastest Tomilov brother, 12 seconds behind the pace. Of course, it was Maxim Tomilov that got closest to topping this route.
Takes that hold from the top the first time.
Brilliant route reading.
So I think he can speed up these next moves.
He really needs to. 1 minute and 30 seconds on the clock. Hits it with the right hand first time. We saw Noah Bake fall off on that move, but he's stuck it. Mohamed Reza Safdarian fell at the next move. Dengin holds it, he goes across himself, kicks in high, matches with the left hand. This is the moment that Alexey Dengin can decide his fate. Takes the right hand, leans out behind him onto that hanging barrel with 1 minute and 3 seconds on the clock. Commits to the figure 9 over the left hand, back to the 4. Takes the top hold, 55 seconds on the clock, into the figure 9, tool in the mouth. Back to the 4. Reaches behind himself for that rope, and as we've said before, this is the crux. He has to find out how he can make this clip. 40 seconds on the clock for Dengin. Reaches down again, pulls hard. Ladies and gentlemen, it's bib 007. The name's Dengin, Alexey Dengin, yeah. And he tops the route in fine style and takes his second gold medal of the season, third gold medal overall. Look at that passion. Alexey Dengin, you are a Bobby Dazzler. You deserve that gold medal. and the team and the people on the floor will be there to congratulate him. Kendra, another sensational performance from a phenomenal Russian athlete.
It was. That was amazing.
Gordon McArthur shouted in his face. Oh, that was so close. I didn't know whether it was going to happen.
Well, he really navigated this little barrel with expertise. You know, he moved to that second hold way faster than anybody else did. He just had his body set up the right way.
There was no tangling the rope. He knew that he just needed to get across himself, and he did. And that is another gold medal.
Beautiful.
Yes, Dengin. So psyched for that guy. I think he's a bit tired now.
I think so.
Amazing work. And we've just had it confirmed that we'll be going directly into the speed finals at 12:30 p.m. local time. Wonxian Xin there, gold medalist in the women's competition. Alexey Dengin, gold medalist in the men's competition. Silver medals taken by Maria Tolokanina of Russia and Maxim Tomilov of Russia. Bronze medals for Ima McSwiggin and Alexey Tomilov.